Welcome to Science Store online classes.
Don't forget to like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel for all the updates.
Welcome to all my students. Today I am taking biology class. So under that we are going to study about the topic living world. Okay. First we are going for the introduction part. Here under the solar system we can see different kinds of planets. About 8 planets are present in the solar system. Under that only in Earth, in a planet Earth, we can see the living organism. We can see living organism in only the planet Earth. So Earth is a home for diverse living organism. Here Earth is a home for diverse living organism. We can see the part of the Earth or the place of the Earth is not uniform in all around the Earth. In all the part we cannot see uniform diversity, or we cannot see uniform places. So here we can see different kinds of habitats. So first we'll write habitats. We can see what is habitats. Habitats are nothing but the place where exactly particular kind of living organism will live. Habitat means the place where living organism will live. That place will call it as habitats. Habitats andre pranigalu athava sasyagalu ya entaha staladalli adu belitade adara mane adara home anna naavu habitats anteve. So in Earth we can see different kinds of habitats. First one we can see forest. Kaadu pradeshagalu. Second, deserts. We can see deserts, that is marubhumi pradeshagalu. Next, we can see mountains. Mountains are nothing but the higher regions on the earth's surface. That we'll call it as mountains, that is ettarada pradeshagalu. Next, oceans, where we can see the salt condition. Here in oceans we can see the salt condition, that is saline condition. Uppu neeru iruvantha sthalagalu, samudragalu. Next you can see polar region, hima pradeshagalu. Next we can see fresh water. Here sihi neerina sthalagalu. So these are the different kinds of habitats we can see on the surface of the Earth. Okay, next we can see in earth we can see various type of living organism. Diversity means different kinds of living organism. Which are the different kinds of living organism we can see? Colorful birds and colorful flowering plants and colorful animals, that we can see in a living organism called in a Earth. Okay, next we'll move to the what is living organism. What is living? The definition, what is living? So in lower classes we also studied about the living things, right? So ನಾವು ನಮ್ಮ ಕೆಳಗಿನ ತರಗತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಜೀವಿಗಳು ಅಂದರೆ ಏನಂತ ಕಲ್ತಿದ್ದೇವೆ. ಜೀವಿಗಳು ಅಂತ ಸಿಂಪ್ಲಿ ಆಗಿ ನಾವು ಹೇಳಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಉಸಿರಾಡುವಂತಹ, ಒಂದು ಸ್ಥಳದಿಂದ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಸ್ಥಳಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋಗುವಂತಹ ಅಥವಾ ಬೆಳವಣಿಗೆಯನ್ನು ತೋರಿಸುವಂತಹ ಜೀವಿಗಳಿಗೆ ನಾವು ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೇವೆ. ಲಿವಿಂಗ್, ಜೀವ ಇರುವಂತಹ ಪ್ರಾಣಿಗಳು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೇವೆ. ಸೊ here based on this the things are divided into different kinds, that is living and non-living. Here we are going to study about the living things. Okay, here the in living things today we are going to study about the different character, or that is main characters of living things. Living organism, different characters of living organism. So first one is the main important characters of living organism is, first one is growth. Growth is an important characteristic of all the living organism. Second one is reproduction. Third one is metabolism. Fourth one is cell organization. And last one is consciousness. This is nothing but the response of living organism to the outer environment. Growth means increase in the size. Reproduction, simply we will tell, reproduction means replicating, means production of new young ones. Metabolism means chemical reactions. Cell organization means arrangement of cells within the organism. Next, consciousness means response to the outer environmental conditions. So we will study one by one. Okay, we are going to study one by one. First one is growth. So we have studied in lower class, right? Growth means increase in the number and size of the cell. Increase in the number and size of the living organism, we'll call it as growth. And these two, increase in number as well as increase in mass, will go together, is an important process taking place in growth. Here, based on the number, we have seen two kinds of living organism, that is multicellular. ಜೀವಕೋಶದ ಆಧಾರದ ಮೇಲೆ ಜೀವಿಗಳನ್ನು ಎರಡು ವಿಧಗಳನ್ನಾಗಿ ಮಾಡಲಾಗಿದೆ. ಒಂದು ಮಲ್ಟಿ ಸೆಲ್ಯುಲಾರ್, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಯೂನಿಸೆಲ್ಯುಲಾರ್. ಇನ್ ಯೂನಿಸೆಲ್ಯುಲಾರ್, ಯೂನಿಸೆಲ್ಯುಲಾರ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಏಕಕೋಶ ಜೀವಿಗಳು, ಇದು ಬಹುಕೋಶ ಜೀವಿಗಳು. ಈ ಎರಡು ಜೀವಿಗಳು ಗ್ರೋತನ್ನು ತೋರಿಸ್ತದೆ, ಬೆಳವಣಿಗೆಯನ್ನು ತೋರಿಸ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಸಿ multicellular organism, how growth takes place in multicellular organism. So in both the organism, cell division, by the process of cell division, they show growth. ಜೀವಕೋಶ ವಿಭಜನೆಯ ಮೂಲಕ ಎಲ್ಲ ಜೀವಿಗಳು ಬೆಳವಣಿಗೆಯನ್ನು ತೋರಿಸ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ಜೀವಕೋಶದ ವಿಭಜನೆ ಒಂದು ಮುಖ್ಯವಾದ ಭಾಗವಾಗಿದೆ ಬೆಳವಣಿಗೆಯಲ್ಲಿ, ಅದೊಂದು ಮುಖ್ಯವಾದ ಭಾಗವಾಗಿದೆ. ಹೇಗೆ ಮಲ್ಟಿಸೆಲ್ಯುಲಾರ್ ಮತ್ತು ಯೂನಿಸೆಲ್ಯುಲಾರಲ್ಲಿ ಜೀವಕೋಶ ವಿಭಜನೆ ಆಗ್ತದೆ ಮತ್ತು ಹೇಗೆ ಬೆಳವಣಿಗೆ ಆಗ್ತದೆ ಅಂತ ನೋಡುವ. ಮಲ್ಟಿಸೆಲ್ಯುಲಾರ್, ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯು ಗಿವ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ಮಲ್ಟಿಸೆಲ್ಯುಲಾರ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್? ಎಸ್, ಅಸ್ human beings are a good example for multicellular organism, and also plants. We can see plants around our environment, that is also very good example for multicellular organism. ಬಹುಕೋಶ ಜೀವಿಗಳಿಗೆ ಅದು ಒಂದು ಬಹಳ ಒಳ್ಳೆಯ ಉದಾಹರಣೆಯಾಗಿದೆ. ಮತ್ತು ಎಲ್ಲ ಪ್ರಾಣಿಗಳು, ಕಣ್ಣಿಗೆ ಕಾಣುವಂಥ ಯಾವುದೇ ಜೀವಿಗಳು ಮಲ್ಟಿಸೆಲ್ಯುಲಾರ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮಲ್ಲಿ ಬರ್ತದೆ. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಯೂನಿಸೆಲ್ಯುಲಾರ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಮೈಕ್ರೋಸ್ಕೋಪಿಕ್, ಸೂಕ್ಷ್ಮ ದರ್ಶಕದಲ್ಲಿ ಕಾಣಿಸುವಂತಹ ಜೀವಿಗಳನ್ನು ನಾವು ಯೂನಿಸೆಲ್ಯುಲಾರ್ ಅಂತೇವೆ. ಸೊ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ಮಲ್ಟಿಸೆಲ್ಯುಲಾರ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್, ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಹಿಯರ್ ದ ಇನ್ ದ ಗ್ರೋತ್ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಸ್ ಟಿಲ್ ದ ಲೈಫ್ ಸೈಕಲ್ ಆಫ್ the plant. Here growth continuous. ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಸಸ್ಯಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಬೆಳವಣಿಗೆ ನೋಡಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಅದು ಸಾಯುವ ತನಕ ಬೆಳವಣಿಗೆಯನ್ನು ತೋರಿಸ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಸ್ ಟಿಲ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಡೈ, ದ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಡೈ, ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೀ ದ ಗ್ರೋತ್. ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯು ಗಿವ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್? trees, right? We can see, we can good give example tree which grow very high and they continuously show growth. Next one is animals. In animals, the growth is till towards the fixed, confined ages. Here, the growth continues till the confined ages. If we take example human beings, the growth is towards 18 to 21. Beyond this, we cannot see further growth, that is increase in the size. Here, if we take in the sense increase in the size, we cannot see growth, increase in the height beyond the age of 21. So, the growth stops in confined age limit, but we cannot tell it as completely growth will stop. Here, the cell division takes place within the cell to replace the lost cell. For example, namge ondu gaya aitu. We had some wounds that will be recovered by the process of cell division. The lost part, lost skin will be recovered. The lost skin will be recovered by the process of cell division. That also a part of growth. But we cannot consider that as a increase in the size. So here growth is 18 to 21 age human being. So the growth stops beyond the age of 21, but cell division takes place to replace the lost part. Okay, next we'll see growth in unicellular organism. So in unicellular organism, the growth takes place by the cell division. Same here in the main difference is unicellular organism, the growth itself is called as a reproduction. So both reproduction and growth is a one and the same process. Here growth takes place by the cell division. Have you studied cell division means a single cell, one cell will divide into, this we'll call it as a parent cell, okay, that will divide into two daughter cells, that will be divided into two daughter cell. Unicellular organism means single cell is considered as a individual organism. Ondu jeeva koshavanna ondu jeevi endu pariganisalagide. So in unicellular organism, single cell is called as a individual organism, and that gave rise to two different cell, and here each cell will act as an individual organism. Got it? Here the single cell divide and produce two daughter cell, and each daughter cell will act as an individual organism. So here this is a example for growth. Cell division is an example for growth, and also we can see the reproduction, that is production of two daughter cells. So in unicellular organism, reproduction as well as growth is one and the same. So you understood the topic growth. Growth means increase in the size of the animal, okay, increase in the size of the living organism, or increase in the number. Size means mass is increase in the number, as well as increase in the mass of the organism is also called as growth. So in few non-living organism is also show increase in the size. So let us consider few examples like mountains. First one, mountains. This is an example for non-living thing. Here mountains, boulders, big rocks is called as boulders, big rock. Next, sand, mounds means a pile or a heap of sand. Maralina guddavanna en heltare, sand mounds or piles. ಈ ಥರ ಇರ್ತದಲ್ಲ ಮರಳಿನ ದಿಬ್ಬ, ಮರಳು ರಾಶಿ ಹಾಕ್ತಾರಲ್ಲ, ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಪೈಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಯಾಂಡ್ and big rocks and mountains. These are non-living things that also show growth. That is, we cannot call it as a growth because that is increase in a size where by the deposition or the accumulation of materials on the surface. Surface alli enagtade materials, sand particles will deposited on the surface. Okay, that increases the size of the non-living thing. So here the growth takes place outside the body. If you consider this is a body, this is a one thing, that here growth takes place outside the surface of the body. So that is a extrinsic process. And next one is, but in living things the deposition or the accumulation of things inside the cell, here accumulation of the new things or the accumulation of particles inside the body. If you consider the plant, the accumulation of the materials or the chemical substance towards the body, towards inner side of the body, but here outside the surface, that is taking place on the surface. So this we cannot consider as a growth. Just it is just the accumulation of particles on the surface, and we cannot consider it as a growth. But in living things, the accumulation, simple accumulation of contents inside the body. We'll move to the one more important concept, that is reproduction. So you have studied what is reproduction in your lower classes. Reproduction means, so here the production of young ones by the parent organism. Here ondu ತಾಯಿ ಜೀವಕೋಶದಿಂದ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಹೊಸ ಜೀವಿಯ ಉತ್ಪಾದನೆಯಾಗುವಂತಹ ವಿಧಾನವನ್ನು ನಾವು ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಅಂತೇವೆ. ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಬೋತ್ ಇನ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ನಾನ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸಾರಿ ಇನ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್. ಓನ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೀ ದ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್, ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ ಆಫ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್. ಯಾಕೆ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಗ್ತದಂದರೆ ಅದರ ಪಾಪ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್ ಸಂಖ್ಯೆಯನ್ನು, ಅದರ ಒಂದು ಇಂಡಿವಿಜುವಲ್ ಒಂದು ಜೀವಿಯ ಸಂಖ್ಯೆಯನ್ನು ಹೆಚ್ಚುವರಿಸಲು ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಒಂದು ಮಹತ್ವಪೂರ್ವ ವಿಧಾನವಾಗಿದೆ. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಬೈ ಟೂ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮಲ್ಟಿಸೆಲ್ಯುಲಾರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಯುನಿಸೆಲ್ಯುಲಾರ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ವಿ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಮಲ್ಟಿಸೆಲ್ಯುಲಾರ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ವಿ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಮಲ್ಟಿಸೆಲ್ಯುಲಾರ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್. ಇನ್ ಮಲ್ಟಿಸೆಲ್ಯುಲಾರ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಇನ್ ಹೈಯರ್, ದೊಡ್ಡ ದೊಡ್ಡ ಜೀವಿಗಳನ್ನು ನಾವು ತಗೊಂಡ್ರೆ ಯಾವ ಥರದ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ ಅಂದರೆ, ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್. Here we can see sexual mode of reproduction. You have studied sexual mode of reproduction. Hege, in sexual mode of reproduction the animals or the organism require two parents. Eredu jeevigala ಅಗತ್ಯತೆ ಇರ್ತದೆ ಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನಲ್ಲಿ. ಒಂದು ಮೇಲ್ ಮತ್ತು ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಫೀಮೇಲ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಗಂಡು ಮತ್ತು ಹೆಣ್ಣಿನ ಗಂಡು ಹೆಣ್ಣು ಒಟ್ಟಾಗಿ ಒಂದು ಜೀವಿಯನ್ನು ಉತ್ಪಾದನೆ ಮಾಡಿದರೆ ಅದನ್ನು ಏನು ಹೇಳ್ತೇವೆ, ಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಪ್ರಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ ದ ನ್ಯೂ ಇಂಡಿವಿಜುವಲ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ ಟು ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ಆ ಹೊಸತಾಗಿ ಬಂದಂತಹ ಜೀವಿಯು ಅದರ ತಂದೆ ತಾಯಿಯನ್ನು ಹೋಲ್ತದೆ. ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಎಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್. ಎಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ ಮೋಡ್ ಆಫ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್. ಹಿಯರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಸೀನ್ ಇನ್ ಫಂಗೈ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸ್ಲೈಟ್ಲಿ ಲೋವರ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್. ಈ ಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಯಾವುದ್ರಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲ ಆಗ್ತದೆ, ಪ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಟ್ಸ್, ಹೈಯರ್ ಪ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಟ್, ಆ್ಯಂಜಿಯೋಸ್ಪರ್ಮಿಕ್ ಪ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಟ್. ಆ್ಯಂಜಿಯೋಸ್ಪರ್ಮಿಕ್ ಪ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಟಲ್ಲಿ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ, ಹೂವಿನ ಭಾಗದಲ್ಲಿ. ಹೂವಿನ ಭಾಗದಲ್ಲಿ ಕೇಸರ ಮತ್ತು ಸ್ಟಿಗ್ಮಾವನ್ನು ನೀವು ನೋಡಿದ್ದೀರಿ. ದ ಆ್ಯಂಥರ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸ್ಟಿಗ್ಮಾ ವಿಲ್ ಫ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಅ ಓವ್ಯೂಸ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸ್ಟಡೀಡ್ ಇನ್ ಯುವರ್ ಲೋವರ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಸ್. ದ್ಯಾಟ್ by that process we can see the seed production. That seed will give rise to a new plant. In animals, the male and female parent will produce an egg and sperms that will fuse and give rise to a new individual. In asexual reproduction, only one single parent is enough. Here in asexual reproduction, one parent is enough. ಒಂದು ಪೋಷಕರ ಅಗತ್ಯತೆಯಿಂದ ಎಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಹಿಯರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಸೀನ್ ಇನ್ ಫಂಗೈ, ಮೋಸಸ್. ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಸೀನ್ ಯೂಶ್ವಲಿ ಇನ್ ಫಂಗೈ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಆಲ್ಗೆ. ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೀ ಇನ್ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಆಲ್ಗೆ. ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ಫಾರ್ ಫಂಗೈ ಹೇಗೆ ಎಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ ಅಂತ ನಾವು ನೋಡುವ. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ದ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೀನ್ ದಿಸ್ ವೈಟ್ ಕಾಟನಿ ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಬ್ರೆಡ್. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಕೀಪ್ ಅ ಬ್ರೆಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಅ ಲಾಂಗ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಇನ್ ಓಪನ್ ಸ್ಪೇಸ್, ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್? ಅ ಕಾಟನಿ ಲೈಕ್ ಮಾಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಅಪಿಯರ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಬ್ರೆಡ್ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್. ಲೇಟರ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಕೀಪ್ ಇಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಅ ಲಾಂಗ್ ಟೈಮ್, ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೀ ಅ ಬ್ಲ್ಯಾಕ್ ಸ್ಪಾಟ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್. ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ದ ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಸ್, ಎಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ದ ಫಂಗಲ್ ಮೈಸಿಲಿಯಂ. ಮೈಸಿಲಿಯಂ ಅಂದರೆ ಫಂಗೈದು ಬಾಡಿಗೆ ಮೈಸಿಲಿಯಂ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಅಂದರೆ ಇದು ಫಿಲಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತದೆ, ಫಂಗೈದು ಫಿಲಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಹೀಗಿರ್ತದೆ. ಇದರ ಫುಲ್ ಹೀಗೆ ವೈಂಡ್ ಆಗಿ ಒಂದು ಮುದ್ದೆಯಾಗಿ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ, ಆ ಮುದ್ದೆಯನ್ನು ಮೈಸೀಲಿಯಂ ಹೇಳ್ತೇವೆ. ಸೊ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಫಿಲಮೆಂಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಗಿವ್ ರೈಸ್ ಟು ಅ ಒಂದು ಸ್ಟಾಕ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್. ಒಂದು ಸ್ಟಾಕ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಒಂದು ದಂಟಿನಂತಹ ರಚನೆಯನ್ನು ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕಾಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಸ್ಪೊರಾಂಜಿಯೋಸ್ಪೋರ್. This we'll call it as sporangiophore. Phore means stalk. Okay? Sporangia means spore-bearing stalk. Okay? That is not required, just for your reference. And that produce a round ball-like structure. That sporangiophore will produce a round ball-like structure. This structure we'll call it as sporangia. Sporangium. This we'll call it as sporangium. And this sporangium contains a large number of minute microscopic spores. Okay, this contains large number of small minute spores, and each spore will develop into a new mycelium. Here you know sporangium alli chikka chikka ಬೀಜದಂತಹ ರಚನೆ ಇರ್ತದೆ, ಆ ರಚನೆ ಆ ಬೀಜಗಳು ಹೊರಗೆ ಬಂದು ಒಂದು ಹೊಸ ಮೈಸೀಲಿಯಂ ಫಂಗಲ್ ಬಾಡಿಯನ್ನು ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ. ಆ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ಸನ್ನು ಈ ಚಿಕ್ಕ ರೌಂಡ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರನ್ನು ಏನು ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ, ದಿಸ್ ರೌಂಡ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಎಸೆಕ್ಷುವಲ್ ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಸ್. ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಸೀನ್ ಇನ್ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಆಲ್ಗೆ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಇನ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ಕಿಂಗ್ಡಮ್, ವೈಲ್ ಸ್ಟಡಿಂಗ್ ದ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ಕಿಂಗ್ಡಮ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ ಈಸ್ ರೀಜನ್ರೇಷನ್. ವಿಲ್ ಸಿ ಹೌ ರೀಜನ್ರೇಷನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್. ರೀಜನ್ರೇಷನ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್, ದ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ರೀಜನರೇಟೆಡ್. ಪುನಃ ಉತ್ಪಾದನೆ ಆಗುವುದು, ಪುನರುತ್ಪಾದನೆ. ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಏನು ಹೇಳಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ರೀಜನರೇಷನನ್ನು ಪುನರುತ್ಪಾದನೆ. ಯಾವ ಭಾಗವನ್ನು ಅದು ಕಳ್ಕೊಂಡಿರ್ತದೋ ಅದು ಪುನಃ ಉತ್ಪಾದನೆ ಆಗುವಂತಹ ವಿಧಾನವನ್ನು ನಾವು ರೀಜನರೇಷನ್ ಅಂತೇವೆ. ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ಗುಡ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ರೀಜನರೇಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ಲನೇರಿಯಾ. So in planaria we can see regeneration, important process called regeneration. Here just draw here the parent, the single body, the planaria body like this. This planarial body will be broken down into small pieces. They may be broken down into small pieces, that is head, stomach and tail part. The three different part will be broken down, and each part, if head is lost, if his
head is separated, that will regenerate the stomach and tail part. And if the this part will be regenerated, if stomach is present, head and tail part will be regenerated. If tail part is lost, if tail part is there, and stomach and head part will be regenerated.
Here in the planaria, one specialized cell is present all over the body called blastoma. So this blastoma will help, which is having a capacity to regenerate the lost part. Here the blastoma cells present in the body will help to regenerate the new part, that is lost part will be regenerated. Common example, can you give a common example for regeneration? This is not similar to that house lizard ana nodidre adra tail part cut agidre adu puna regenerate aagutade, but that is not the regeneration, that will call it as regeneration, but it is not a process of sexual reproduction. There we cannot call it as a sexual reproduction, just a regeneration of the lost part. Andre head part adu loss aadre puna regenerate madudilla, only tail part will be regenerated. But here in this planaria, regeneration means it is a process of reproduction. Okay, next one is fourth
process is fragmentation.
This is also very important process of reproduction. Fragmentation means tundariyuvike, fragmentation. Here this can be seen in some of the fungi, filamentous fungi, some of the algae. We can see the fragmentation process in some of the algae, and also some of the mosses, protonema of moss. Moss is nothing but a type of bryophyte. In this we can see the process of reproduction called fragmentation. We'll see how I'll give example how the fragmentation process take place in filamentous fungi, algae, protonema. First one is, can you give example for filamentous fungi? Okay, these all the smaller fungi, I'll give example of algae. Can easily give the example for filamentous algae, that is Spirogyra. You have seen in a water bodies a small hair, green hair like structure, that is nothing but the Spirogyra. There we can see the spiral arrangement of the chloroplast that you are going to study in detail. So in this is a filamentous structure. Filamentous structure andre thread tarada bhagagalidre adanna filamentous structure ante heltare. Here the plant part is broken down into different small pieces. The plant part is broken into small pieces, and that can be carried by a water current to different places. Bere bere jagakke ee chikka chikka piece anna adu tokkondu hogtade, and each filament, each fragment, each piece will be developed into a new plant. That can be developed into a new plant. Okay, that can be developed into a new
filamentous algae. So by this process fragmentation takes place,
and that can also seen in protonema of moss. Here you have seen the moss. Moss means it is a type of bryophyte. The moss will produce moss andre yavudu gotaita nimma gode. You can see the small plants seen on the walls of compounds or your on your walls. You can see small, very small plants like this leaf,
and that produces a small one spore like structure.
We used to play cockfight in these plants, in these spores. You remember that plant, I think.
So that produces a spores.
This round shaped structure will produce a small spores. Okay, that spore will germinate and produce a small, before go, it will not directly develop into a new plant. Instead they develop into a small filamentous like structure.
ಯಾವುದು ಮಾಸಿದು ಸ್ಪೋರ್ ಹೊರಗೆ ಬಂದು ಅದು ಒಂದು
ಗಿಡವಾಗಿ ಬೆಳೆಯುವುದಿಲ್ಲ, ಅದರ ಬದಲಾಗಿ
ಒಂದು ದಾರದಂತಹ ರಚನೆಯನ್ನು ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ಫಿಲಮೆಂಟಸ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್
ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕಾಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಅ ಪ್ರೋಟೋನೀಮಾ. ದಿ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕಾಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಅ ಪ್ರೋಟೋನೀಮಾ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಪ್ರೋಟೋನೀಮಾ ಗಿವ್ ರೈಸ್ ಟು ಅ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಬರ್ಡ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಬರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಲೇಟರ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಅ ನ್ಯೂ plant. Here this protonema will break into small pieces, and each piece will go to new place and produces a new plant. Okay, they produces to begin new plant. This type of reproduction
we'll call it as a fragmentation.
Here in fragmentation the parent body will be broken down into a small pieces, and each small piece will develop into a new individual organism. ಒಂದು ಹೊಸ ಜೀವಿಯ ಅಥವಾ ಹೊಸ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ನ ಉತ್ಪಾದನೆ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಟೇಕ್ ಆಲ್ಗೆ, ದೇ ಡೆವಲಪ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಅ ನ್ಯೂ ಫಿಲಮೆಂಟಸ್ ಆಲ್ಗೆ. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಟೇಕ್ ದ ಪ್ರೋಟೋನೀಮಾ, ಇಟ್ ಗಿವ್ ರೈಸ್ ಟು ಅ ನ್ಯೂ ಮಾಸ್. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಟೇಕ್ ಅ ಫಂಗೈ, filamentous fungi, it is also develop into a new fungi. Okay, so these are the different example for fragmentation. And let us see what is the difference between fragmentation and regeneration. Regeneration means the lost part will be regenerated. Andre yava part adu kalkondirtade adanna produce martade, hosa jeevanna produce madudilla adu. Yava bhagavanna adu kalkondirtade and aa bhagavanna adu utpadane martade. Fragmentation alli en aagtade, ondu jeevi chikka 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 tundugalagi berpadtade, aa ತುಂಡುಗಳು ಒಂದು ಹೊಸ ಜೀವಿಯಾಗಿ ಉತ್ಪಾದನೆಯಾಗ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಮೇನ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ರೀಜನರೇಷನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಫ್ರ್ಯಾಗ್ಮೆಂಟೇಷನ್. ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯು ಟೆಲ್ ದ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್?
ರೀಜನರೇಷನಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗ್ತದೆ, ಫ್ರ್ಯಾಗ್ಮೆಂಟೇಷನ್. ಐಲ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ರೈಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಶಾರ್ಟ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್. ಸೊ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ regeneration, only regenerated part is produced, and here the new individual, is produced from the fragment. An example, here example planaria, and here example fungi, algae andre ಪಾಚಿ, ಫಂಗೈ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪ್ರೋಟೋನೀಮಾ. protonema of
Mars. These are the example. If the difference will be asked for the exam between the regeneration and fragmentation, you have to write these difference and you should remember the difference. Next we'll move to the next important topic. Important one more reproduction is budding. Okay, one more important reproduction process is budding. Mogguvike. You in your lower classes we have studied about the different kinds of reproduction. Under that you have studied the budding. Even in Kannada medium also you have studied budding means mogguvike. Here what happens, the plant body is present, for example yeast. Okay, we can take example yeast. It is a unicellular fungus. Yavadakke use martare yeast anna, bread, for the preparation of bread. You have heard about the yeast, right? It is a unicellular organism, contains a single cell which may be arranged one above the other, itara chain tara arrange agirbodu, but this is a unicellular organism. Here the small outgrowth will be developed, and here the nucleus undergo division and that nucleus will move towards the bud. So that will move towards the bud and this bud will later detached from the parent body. ಈ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ ಬಾಡಿಯಿಂದ ಈ ಬಡ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತದಲ್ಲ ಮೊಗ್ಗು, ಅದೇನಾಗ್ತದೆ ಪೇರೆಂಟಿಂದ ಬೇರ್ಪಡ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ಬೇರ್ಪಟ್ಟಂತಹ ಮೊಗ್ಗು ಏನಾಗ್ತದೆ, ಒಂದು ಹೊಸ ಈಸ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಪರಿವರ್ತನೆ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ದ ಬಡ್ ವಿಲ್ ಡಿಟ್ಯಾಚಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಡೆವಲಪ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಅ ನ್ಯೂ ಈಸ್ಟ್ ಸೆಲ್. ಓಕೆ, ಬೈ ದಿಸ್ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ ದ ಈಸ್ಟ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಗೋ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಗಿವ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ Hydra. Can also give example, one more example, that is Hydra for budding process. Let us see how the Hydra shows budding. Okay, so Hydra. So Hydra hegirtade, so stalk irtade, there is stalk irtade and they have a 10 finger like structures. Then finger like structure, that we'll call it as, this structure we'll call it as Hydra. Here on the body you can see a small outgrowth. Okay, small outgrowth will be seen. Later the tentacles will be formed and they also give one nucleus to this. They undergo nuclear division and the one nucleus move to this bud, and later the small bud like structure will detaches from the parent body and this develop into a new Hydra. They develop into a new Hydra structure. So this is a important reproduction seen in yeast and Hydra. This is the reproduction process is called as budding. Okay, very important. Now done. Next one process is cell. In unicellular organism, simple fission or cell division itself results for the reproduction process. That can be example cell division, or you can also call it as a fission. Fission means ondiddadu eradaguvanta process ana fission helteve. So cell division is also a type of fission process where single cell will divide and produce two cells. Can you give me example for unicellular organism? First one example, bacteria. Next, some algae, unicellular algae.
like Chlamydomonas, like that. Okay, next, some of the fungi is also unicellular in
unicellular, so that undergo simple cell division. Let us take a example, bacteria. How bacteria?
So we can see Bacillus bacteria, rod shaped bacteria is called as Bacillus bacteria, which contains outerly cell wall irtade, olage nucleus irtade, so all the cell organelles. So here this will call it as a parent cell, so that will undergo division. First enagtade nuclear division aagtade, ee ondidda nucleus erad aagtade, so later eradada nucleus ondidda nucleus erad aagtade, eradidda nucleus madhyadalli cell wall formation aagi enagtade eradu hosa bacteria galannu kodtade. So these
individual bacteria, so the single bacteria will give rise to two individual bacteria by the process of cell division. This also a type of reproduction. So this is a important and defining character. Growth and reproduction is a defining character of a living organism. You should remember, growth and reproduction is a defining character of the living organism. So this cannot be seen in non-living things. We cannot see these processes in non-living things, where it all, we can also see the simple fragmentation or fission in non-living things, but the fused or the fragmented particle will not grow. Here if you take one rock, enagtade rock iddadu or a stone particle, it will break into two, right? It will break into two rock particle, but here this rock particle will not grow further. This particle will not grow further, so we cannot consider this process as a reproduction. And even the increase in size, we cannot tell it as a growth. Okay, next we'll see few organism is also infertile. Infertile means they are not able to produce younger ones. For example, first we'll take the example
moles. Example, mules. Next, worker bee. Next one is infertile humans. So how?
These are the example for the organism which do not show any reproduction, that is they do not produce any younger ones. So mules is nothing but
the organism or the individual produced by male donkey and female horse. This is a hybrid produced by male donkey and female horse.
The individual produced between these two animals, the hybrid produced between these two animals is called as mules. These are infertile. Usually the animals or the plants of different kinds andre donkey matte horse bere bere tarada pranigalu adra madhye breeding madidre athwa adra मेल मत्ते फीमेल ओट्टु माडिद्रे यंग वन प्रोड्यूस आगतदे, बट दे आर इनफर्टाइल मीन्स दे नॉट एबल टू प्रोड्यूस यंग वन्स अन्नु प्रोड्यूस माडलिक्के एबल आगिरोदिल्ल. नेक्स्ट
वर्कर बी.
नीवु हनी बी नोडिदिरि अल्वा, हनी बीस विच प्रोड्यूसर्स हनीस. यू हैव सीन द हनी कूम नोडिदिरल्ल, अ बिग कूम jenu gudu, so that is seen. So there you can see large number of honeybees. You have seen a large number of honeybees, where there all the honeybees are not fertile there. Here there are three kinds of bees are present in a beehive. There are three types of bees present in a beehive. That is, first one is a fertile male, that we'll call it as a drone, and worker bee, which take care of the beehive, means construction of the beehive and collection of the nectars, that is carried out by worker bee, and one female bee present, fertile female bee present, that we'll call it as a queen bee. You have heard about this. So that's male and queen is fertile, but the worker bees are not fertile. They are produced by parthenocarpic process. So andre, that we are going to study later. So enagtade ee worker bee, these are female but they are infertile, and these bee carry out the bee construction process, so they are not able to produce the younger ones. They are not able to produce the younger one. This division we can also see in termites. ಗೆದ್ದಲು ಹುಳದಲ್ಲಿ ಸಹ ನಾವು ಇಂಥ ಡಿವಿಷನನ್ನು ನೋಡ್ಬೋದು. ಮತ್ತು ವ್ಯಾಸ್ಪಲ್ಲಿ ಕೆಲವೊಂದು ದೊಡ್ಡ ವ್ಯಾಸ್ಪ್ ಅಂದರೆ ವ್ಯಾಸ್ಪ್, ದೇರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ದ ಡಿವಿಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಇನ್ಸೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಇನ್ಫರ್ಟೈಲ್ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ಸ್. ಈವನ್ ಸರ್ಟೇನ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್, ದೀಸ್ ರಿಸಲ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಸರ್ಟೇನ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್, ಫಿಸಿಕಲ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಇಂಟರ್ನಲ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್, ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಎಬ್ನಾರ್ಮ್ಯಾಲಿಟೀಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ದ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ರಿಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಆರ್ಗನ್ಸ್, ಆರ್ ದ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟರ್ನಲ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ರೀಮ್ ಹೀಟ್, ದಟ್ ಆರ್ ಆ ರಿಸಲ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಇನ್ಫರ್ಟೈಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಇನ್ಫರ್ಟಿಲಿಟಿ ಇನ್ ದ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ಸ್. ಬಟ್ these are the living organism, even though they won't carry out the process called reproduction, they are the living beings, they are the living organisms which undergo various other process. Andre berella process ana adu martade, but reproduction madlikke adu able agirudilla. So reproduction madlikke able alla anta adre adana naavu organism alla anta consider madlikagudilla. These are all living organisms, but they won't carry the reproduction process, which is also important process, but under certain condition these animals are not able to reproduce. So next we'll move to the one more important topic, that is metabolism. So here note down the different processes, these different characters of living organism. That is, one more is metabolism. So metabolism andre eno, metabolism is nothing but the chemical reaction taking place within the living organism to carry out the life process. So life process anna living process anna carry out madlike yavdella rasayanika kriyegalu jeeviya olage aagtade adanna naavu metabolism, that chemical reaction we'll call it as a metabolism. So you have metabolism and venta, the chemical reaction that taking place inside the living organism to carry out the life process. Life process ige athava jeeva irlike entella agatyategalide adakke aguvanta rasayanika kriyegalanna naavu metabolism ant heltare. Metabolism amalli two process ide, one is anabolism, two types ide, one is anabolism, next one is catabolism. These are the, that is not given but very important, you should know this. What is anabolism, what is catabolism, these are the two important chemical reaction comes under the metabolism process, called this two collectively called as a metabolism. Anabolism is a building process, where here before that, if you take a living organism, all the living organism, all the non-living things which are made up of chemical components, you should know all the living as well as non-living things are made up of chemical components, but the chemical constituents, yavudella rasayanika vastugalide adu non living thing matte living thing alli bere bere agirtade, but all these things are made up of chemicals that you should know. So organism alli aguvanta chemical reaction horage non living things alli agalla, non living things alli aguvanta chemical reaction athava rasayanika kriye jeevigala olage agodilla. So metabolism, which will not takes place only in the living organism, so anabolism and catabolism process, which takes place inside the living organism. Anabolism andre building process, andre that is a building process, building up of a new molecules, andre one molecule anna madidre iga glucose plus glucose, for example glucose plus glucose and glucose, a large number of glucose will produce a starch molecule. Large number of glucose molecules, a long chain of glucose molecules, this glucose molecule will fuse and form a long chain of glucose, that will call it as a starch. So that collectively produces a complex compound, that will call it as a starch. Starch andre pista ಎಲ್ಲಿರ್ತದೆ, ನಮ್ಮ ಆಹಾರದಲ್ಲಿರ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಚ್ ಏನಾಗ್ತದೆ, ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಚ್ ಬ್ರೇಕ್ ಆದಾಗ ನಮಗೆ ಗ್ಲೂಕೋಸ್ ಸಿಗ್ತದೆ. ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಚ್ ಯಾವುದರಿಂದ ಆಗಿರ್ತದೆ, ಗ್ಲೂಕೋಸ್ನ ತುಂಬ ಗ್ಲೂಕೋಸ್ಗಳು ಸೇರಿ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಚ್ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ಗಳಾಗಿರ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್, ದ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಅನಬಾಲಿಕ್ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕೆಟಬಾಲಿಸಮ್, ಕೆಟಬಾಲಿಸಮ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ destructive process, means breaking down of a complex molecules, reverse process. Enagtade this starch molecule will break down into a smaller molecule by the help of enzyme and produces a simple molecules, that will call it as a glucose. This starch molecule broken down aagi glucose molecule aagi produce aagtade. Ee process anna ida reverse process anna other example you can give some other fructose athava yavadadru carbohydrate enagtade, carbohydrate yavaga nama usirata kriyeli carbohydrate break aagi namge shaktiyanna korudu, carbon dioxide neeragi vibhajane hondi shaktiyanna kortade. So starch takondre starch enagtade vibhajane hondi glucose ಅಂಶಗಳನ್ನು ಕೊಡ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ಈ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸನ್ನು ಏನು ಹೇಳ್ತೇವೆ, ಕೆಟಬಾಲಿಸಮ್. ಕೆಟಬಾಲಿಸಮ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ ವೇರ್ ದ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬ್ರೋಕನ್, ಬ್ರೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಕಾಂಪ್ಲೆಕ್ಸ್ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ ಟು ಗೆಟ್ ಅ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಕಾಂಪೌಂಡ್ಸ್. ಟು ಗೆಟ್ ಅ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಕಾಂಪೌಂಡ್, ಕಾಂಪ್ಲೆಕ್ಸ್ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಬ್ರೋಕನ್ ಡೌನ್, ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕಾಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಕೆಟಬಾಲಿಸಮ್. ಅನಬಾಲಿಸಮ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಕನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್, ಬಿಲ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ ವ್ಯಾರ್ ಕಾಂಪ್ಲೆಕ್ಸ್ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಸಿಂಥಸೈಸ್ಡ್. ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಈ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಚ್ ಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್, ಪ್ರೋಟೀನ್ ಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್, ಅಮೈನೋ ಆ್ಯಸಿಡ್ ಇಂದ ಪ್ರೋಟೀನ್ ಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ, ಅದು ಅನಬಾಲಿಸಮ್ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ಸಿಗೆ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತದೆ. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಟು ಮೂವ್ ಟು ದ ಸೊ ಹೌ ಮೆಟಬಾಲಿಸಮ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್. ಸೊ ಇನ್ ಯುನಿಸೆಲ್ಯುಲರ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್, ಸೊ ಬೋತ್ ಇನ್ ಯುನಿಸೆಲ್ಯುಲರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ multicellular organism we can see the important process called metabolism. We can see the important process called metabolism. Here all the organism is made up of large number of chemical compounds and they carry out thousands of chemical reaction. They are able to carry out the thousands of chemical reaction and all this reaction taking place within the cell. ಒಂದು ಜೀವಕೋಶ ತಗೊಂಡ್ರೆ ಯಾವುದೇ ಮೆಟಬಾಲಿಕ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಆಗ್ತದೆ, ವಿದಿನ್ ದ ಸೆಲ್. ಜೀವಕೋಶದ ಒಳಗೆ ಔಟರ್ಲಿ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕವರ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಸೆಲ್ ಮೆಂಬ್ರೇನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇನ್ಸೈಡ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ದ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ದ ಸೆಲ್ ಆರ್ಗನೆಲ್ಸ್ ಮೈಟೊಕಾಂಡ್ರಿಯಾ Golgi complex. So next, ribosomes.
endoplasmic reticulum. These are the important organelles present in the cell,
and all this chemical reaction taking place,
all the metabolic reaction taking place
within the cell. So thousands of reaction takes place within the cell for the production of different chemical compounds. So the chemical compounds produced by the process of metabolism, we'll call it as a biomolecules. So ಏನು ಕೆಟ್ಟ ಮೆನಬಾಲಿಕ್ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆದಂಥ ಅಥವಾ ಮೆಟಬಾಲಿಕ್ ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆದಂಥ ರಾಸಾಯನಿಕ ವಸ್ತುಗಳನ್ನು ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಕಾಂಪೌಂಡ್ಸನ್ನು ನಾವೇನಂತೇವೆ ಬಯೋ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ಸ್.
ಯಾಕೆ ನಾವು ಬಯೋ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ಸ್ ಹೇಳ್ತೇವೆ,
ವೈ ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಬಯೋ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ಸ್? ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ಸೈಡ್ ದ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್. ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಕಂಪೌಂಡ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್. ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆದಂತಹ ಮತ್ತು ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮಲ್ಲಿ ಇರುವಂತಹ ರಾಸಾಯನಿಕ ವಸ್ತುಗಳನ್ನು ನಾವೇನಂತೇವೆ ಬಯೋ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ಸ್. ವಿಲ್ ಕಾಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಬಯೋ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ಸ್. ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ದಿಸ್. We are going to study what are the biomolecules present in a living system. So biomolecules andre en anta gotaytala, the chemical compounds or the chemical complexes present inside the living system as well as produced by the living system. Yakandre kelavondu protein galella namge artificially siktade, but they should be produced from the living organisms. So these are the biomolecules. Even the chemical reaction may takes place inside the may takes place in a non living things, but we cannot call it as a metabolism. We call it as a simply chemical reaction. Adanna nave en anteve simply chemical reaction anta helteve. We cannot call it as a metabolism because that is taking place outside the living organism or present on the non living things alli aguvanta rasayanika kriyegalanna naavu rasayanika kriyegalanteve metabolism anta heludilla. Rasayanika kriye jeevigalalli aadre adanna metabolism anteve. So this is a unique process taking place only inside the living organism. So for this study we can also carry out some of the metabolic reaction under in vitro condition andre laboratory condition alli kelavondu metabolic process anna naavu carry out maadabodu andre antaha vidhanagalanna study purpose ge namma odigagi maadabodu, but that we cannot here metabolic process taking place in vitro ಇನ್ ವಿಟ್ರೋ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ಲ್ಯಾಬೊರೇಟ್ರಿ ಅಂದರೆ ಲ್ಯಾಬ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಮಾಡುವಂತಹ ರಾಸಾಯನಿಕ ಕ್ರಿಯೆ ಅಥವಾ ಯಾವುದೇ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆರಿಮೆಂಟ್ಗಳನ್ನು ನಾವು ಇನ್ ವಿಟ್ರೋ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೇವೆ. ಲ್ಯಾಬ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಸಹ ಹೇಳ್ತೇವೆ, ಟೆಕ್ನಿಕಲಿ ಇನ್ ವಿಟ್ರೋ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಹೇಳ್ತೇವೆ. ಸೊ ಇನ್ ಲ್ಯಾಬೊರೇಟ್ರಿ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಟೇಕ್ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಮೆಟಬಾಲಿಕ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ ಸೆಲ್ free medium, that is cell free medium. We can carry out some of the process under cell free medium. Here the chemical reaction we cannot call it as a metabolism, simply we call it as a living reactions. We cannot call it as a metabolism. Okay, today in next class I'll continue with the next topic, that is cell organization and consciousness. Okay, in next class we are going to just refresh, summarize the topic, and we'll continue with the next topic.
Don't forget to like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel for all the updates.